communicate my DNA and dismay, and I'm really excited for that. Yeah. So it is my topic to talk about contemporary Korean music, Korean piano music, and its Western influence. So what do you think of when you hear the word Korean music, Korean traditional music? That is South Korea, we hosted Winter Olympic recently. So you can see there's a marking of the Olympic at the top. And this Korean traditional singer, he sang the Korean traditional music during the opening ceremony. It was very impressive, and he had really great comment after this. Or K-pop, Korean pop, you know, Gangnam Style. Although Koreans have maintained a rich heritage of traditional music, there are also many trends in Korean popular and art music that are influenced by Western traditions. So, how did Western music come to Korea? As a result of industrial revolution, Western Europeans were producing more than they could sell domestically. So, they had to seek out new markets in different continents. Therefore, Europeans explored Africa, Middle East, and Asia in 19th century. When French and American trade ships explored Korea, they brought missionaries on the same ships to introduce the Christian religion. Western music was first introduced in Korea in 1885 by missionaries who built schools and churches to teach their religious faith and Christian hymns. So picture here, the three missionaries at the bottom, at the top is Korean guys with the traditional customs. And the second picture, I thought that is really like funny to me. There's Western missionaries who wear this Korean traditional custom, and then no fans. You can see they try to just pose for picture. Funny to me. Later, from 1910 to 1945, Korea was under forced colonization by Japan. To control Koreans, Japanese government tried to indoctrinate Korean scholars in the Japanese style. This picture of the Japanese military flying the imperial flag in Seoul, South Korea. In the right photo, the Japanese government persecuted the Chinese and Koreans just as Nazi persecuted the Jewish in the different side of the world. After the United States dropped the atomic bombs in Hiroshima and Nagasaki in World War II, Korea was automatically granted independence from Japanese colonization. Those maps show the situation between 1945 and 1950. Against the Koreans' wishes, they were unfortunately involved in the Cold War between Russia and China and the United States and the UN. Those two political powers met in the Korean Peninsula and started a war which is known as the Korean War, 1950. As a result of the Korean War, American culture and musical trend were introduced in South Korea. Now Korean history and tradition intertwine with aspect of modern culture in South Korea. Today, I would like to introduce two Korean composers who use Western forms and techniques but kept Korean tunes and motifs in their works, and how they combine Western musical structures and traditional Korean tunes and melodies in their works. Jung Kim and Quentin Kim There are various reasons why I chose them for my research. They represent two different generations that span the Korean War. They studied both in Korea and Western countries. They are interested in Korean tradition and culture and used Western musical structures with inspiration from traditional Korean tunes, melodies, and culture. Jeongil Kim was born in 1933 in Korea. During the Korean War in 1950, he joined the Korean military band. After the war, he studied composition at Seoul National University. When he was 37, he decided to go to Germany, where he studied Western music conventions with Yoon, who is a very famous person. From 1970 through 1972. His exposure to Korean music during his time in the military, mixed with his professional training in Western conventions, result in attractive expressions of Korean tradition tunes with Western musical structures. 고풍, Memories of Childhood, composed in 1982 and include four movements. Each movement contains an evocative title such as 향합, 남학신, 옥비녀, and 문풍지. He concentrates on projecting culture, traditional scenes, and his memories of childhood to younger generations and non-Koreans who never had the same experience he had. I would like to explain how he expresses Korean tradition customs in this piece through musical symbolism. The first movement portrays the Korean funeral ceremony. The title 향합, 향 means incense, and hap means the case or jar. The Koreans believe that burning incense creates a link between the deceased and their family. In major one, the caudal passages represent the rising of smoke from burning incense. In major 5 to 6, the caudal expresses death and sadness, which he emulates Korean funeral music. Let's listen to Korean funeral music. It is like a Korean requiem. When you heard the Korean funeral music that I with the Korean funeral music. The composer's symbolic intentions is to represent the Korean belief in links between living and death. Hyunki was born in 1976 in Seoul. He is active as a pianist, educator, and composer. He earned DMA piano performance in Juilliard School of Music, and he's a professor of piano at Busan National University in South Korea. As a native Korean, he is deeply interested in Korean tradition and culture. As a composer, he composed mainly solo piano works in Western forms, such as prelude and fugue, sonatas, and female variations. Variations on an ancient Korean melody is written for solo piano. He composed originally in 2008 and revised in 2010. The theme is from Doraji, which is a Korean traditional tune around the 18th century. You can see the picture over there. Doraji is the bloom flower. Korean is the root of this flower. This song illustrates happiness at the harvest of this plant. So Korean, we just farmed it, and we eat the root, and they are really happy. So that is the main theme of this traditional song. I found a recording of Korean traditional music singer singing this Doraji. So you'll hear thing a little bit. You can hear the difference in vocal techniques compared to Western tradition and South Korean's vocal technique. It's different. Quinton used this original traditional song for those piano variations, except a couple things. In major 2 to 3, I just marked with the red box. He used major 6 rather than perfect 5th. And the original key is major, but he modulated to minor key. This is the Doraji theme, how we changed it. So